Good evening. First tonight, after appealing for gentler politics just yesterday, Prime Minister Kevin Rudd has thrown a giant-sized grenade into the debate about asylum seekers, suggesting if Tony Abbott is elected, his plans to send back the boats could spark an armed conflict with Indonesia. Political editor Hugh Remington joins us now with the latest details from Canberra. Hugh, is anyone taking this claim seriously?
Well, Tash, the opposition is certainly taking it seriously. They say it is outrageous, reckless and irresponsible. That's just some of the more printable words that they're using at the moment. Kevin Rudd certainly dramatically upping the stakes in the asylum seeker policy debate by claiming a change of government could lead to a scrap with our largest neighbour.
In a fighting mood, Kevin Rudd accusing Tony Abbott of endangering the country in promising to turn back boats against Indonesian opposition.
I really wonder whether he's trying to risk some sort of conflict with Indonesia.
What might start as a diplomatic tip, he says, could escalate.
Confrontasi with Indonesia evolved over a set of words and turned into something else.
Confrontasi was a four-year conflict in the 60s that dragged in Australian troops.
It is a massive overreach, it is a shocking diplomatic gaffe, and he should retract it before he does any more damage.
Sources say the Prime Minister hopes to visit the Indonesian President next week as the opposition looks to blame Mr. Rudd personally for the flood of recent boats.
This is a man who is simply clueless when it comes to stopping the boats.
The Prime Minister says his new frontbench team will be sworn in on Monday.
I want to make some policy changes.
He's hinted those could include reversing welfare cuts for single parents, taking another look at the mining tax, giving himself an extra 2 weeks on the education reforms to talk the states around, and possibly dumping the carbon tax in favour of a much lower floating carbon price.
If you were to move to flexible pricing earlier, there would be a massive hit on the budget.
But unlike last time when he was fatally reluctant to consult with his colleagues, this time he says he will.
Just chill for a while, in fact, chill for quite a bit.
Internal party reform is another ambition sharpened by recent scandals.
I am revolted by what I have seen unfold in New South Wales.
As for an election date, not a word.
Well, the Prime Minister has a busy work schedule immediately ahead of him, but of course this is Kevin 24/7. Among his ambitions, he wants a televised debate in the next 2 weeks with Tony Abbott, he says, on the subject of debt and deficit. Tash.
An extraordinary week in Australian politics. Thank you, Hugh.